they say that I'm from India, and here people only pray to God for personal gain, like I'd like a car, I'd like more money, etc., etc. Now, how does this sit with Hinduism? Is it right to go and ask God, like your personal ATM, get me this?
Look, you call you God your real father and real mother. So if you can't turn to him when you need something, why do you call him your real father and mother? We sing, oh, God is my real father. Real. So of course you turn to him. I'm not saying it's a good idea. I'm simply saying that is understandable. It's human nature. We look to somebody who is perhaps stronger and bigger and better than us to in a way grant our kind of worldly requirements. Understandable. And I'm not saying anything wrong. Why? The Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says there are different kinds of devotees I have. Hmm. And one kind of devotee, this is Krishna in Bhagavad Gita, so it's a very central feature, central scripture of the Hindus. One kind of devotees I have, says Krishna, are artharthi. Sanskrit being meaning they want something from me. In fact, look, quite a lot of temples today are very popular. I'm not going to mention any names throughout India and in the UK as well, where the devotees go and they know that if they do this particular worship ceremony of God and say, look, God, if you can get me to do this and get my son in the top university, I will offer this much to you. Hmm. They do commerce with God. And of course, God says, no problem, do commerce, whether I play ball or not is a separate thing, but you are allowed to play, try and do commerce with me. Anyway, this is a good part. It's okay, you turn to God and try and do some business with him. But the negative part is this. You must not treat God as the fourth emergency service. Hmm. That's what we are doing. And that is not right. Surely not right. Because then you say, everything else fails, so now emergency chain, God. Hmm. And in fact, in most of the soap operas or even Hindi films, you see this all the time. You know, the goody-goody is getting beaten up, he's in the hospital, about to die, and then the oscilloscope goes tick, 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 and the wife is praying, Mother Goddess, please save me, and the bells tinkle, ding, ding, and the person recovers. So this is, we use God as the fourth emergency service. Even the doctors fail, God will step in. So look, if you think God is your real father, I'm not here to stop you. But I say, look, try and ask from us something much more higher than your worldly requirements from God. Why should you just look for health, wealth? Of course, we need it. At the same time, focus on God, not just as kind of this kind of fourth emergency service, but as somebody who will give you spiritual enlightenment. Ask for the highest from God. He's such a high power person. It's like going to the king and saying, can I have some marbles? Hmm. Ask for diamonds. This is what they advise. So when you interact with God, try and ask for the highest. Don't ask for the lowest. Don't say, ask for, get away with just marbles, I'm happy. Go for the diamonds. Ask for spiritual experience. Experience, spiritual experience. And if your love is genuine, your intensity is very strong, you will get it. That's the promise of our tradition.